Like, I could just flank her right here, and then we can get Ellis.
And Commissioner, yeah. Commissioner.
Dr. Rivera.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's great. Dr. Rivera. Yeah. Maybe just figure out just a hair. It will be good.
Up here, I don't want to be like, here, I'll come over here and stand so that she has a seven.
How are you?
Good morning. I'm very, very proud to be at Sheldon ISD's C.E. King High School, and we're here with Principal Saeed and Superintendent Webster and just a group of incredible administrators, as well as Commissioner Rodney Ellis. We're in his precinct, and Dr. Rivera from Harris County Public Health. I just got done visiting with some students, some public health staff, and because this is one of the schools where we've been providing vaccines, I want to first thank all these folks who are joining with us in the effort to vaccinate students in our community to get us to where we need to be. And of course, our Harris County Public Health team, who's been working, some of the folks here are now working the vaccination sites, but started out working our testing sites over a year ago and have been going nonstop to support our community. So far in terms of vaccines, the community is really stepping up. At least 35.8% of all residents have been fully vaccinated. Over 45% of all residents in Harris County have had at least one dose. As far as those who are eligible, those who are over 12 years old, over 43% of the total of those who are over 12 years old have been fully vaccinated as of today. And almost 55% of Harris County residents over 12 have had at least one shot, which is a huge deal for our community. Once we can get over 50% of the total population fully vaccinated, it's gonna be a big turning point, and we're already seeing the positive impacts of the vaccination rates. Now, the efforts to get folks vaccinated don't happen on its own. It's because of folks like these, it's because of folks like our public health department. And that's why, since vaccines became available in December, we've been working to take vaccines to the community. We have visited over 218 locations throughout Harris County, including schools like C.E. King High School, including churches, communities of faith, all kinds of sites, some parks, some community centers. Now that the Pfizer vaccine is approved for kids, we have hit 39 schools so far that we've visited to provide vaccinations all throughout the county, and we've got even more lined up in the next couple of weeks. So this is something we're going to continue to do. Our school vaccination sites, we aim around at least 100 students, but we're seeing a huge number of folks come by in these vaccination sites, especially compared to the other ones. And of course, we have our NRG Park vaccination site, which has been a model for the nation in terms of the various FEMA sites. We've also been doing a lot to get the word out. We've done a media campaign, a door knocking campaign. We've done a gift card raffles at NRG Park. And today we're announcing one more initiative to encourage the uptake of vaccinations. Starting next week, we will award scholarships of $5,000, one scholarship award per week for at least 10 weeks through a raffle for students who've been vaccinated through Harris County Public Health. The scholarships will be used to cover tuition, room and board, books, to any community college, public college, or university in the state of Texas. And any student who's been vaccinated through Harris County Public Health under the age of 17 or younger will qualify, anybody who's received the vaccine by the time of the raffle. To be eligible, they need to not have graduated high school as well. And so we're very, very excited to be announcing that here. The first drawing will be Thursday, June 10th, and we'll announce the winner on June 11th. We'll keep doing that weekly for at least 10 weeks, and then we'll see how the program is going. The raffle is modeled after similar programs throughout the country that have been working. When we began doing our gift card raffles at Energy Park, we saw a doubling of the number of folks that were coming just in the following week. After that, we've had some weather, so it's hard to measure. But as soon as we got, we went from 1,000 folks a day to 2,000 folks a day. In Ohio, they announced a lottery program. Within the week of announcing that program, the vaccine uptake went up 28%. We've seen New Mexico announce a lottery. State of Washington is going to be doing something similar today. We wanted to focus on our students. We wanted to do this raffle program, and so we're very, very excited to unveil it. If you're still a student on the fence about getting a vaccine, if you are a parent on the fence about getting your child vaccinated, I hope this will be the last little incentive to get you over the edge. We have a majority of the community has gotten at least one shot by now, the eligible community. And so if you are over the age of 12 and you've not gotten a vaccine, you're now in the minority, and we need you to get through this virus. Our numbers continue looking up, but that comes because of the folks that have been vaccinated. Vaccines are available for everybody over the age of 11, so 12 and over, at NRG Park, Tuesday through Sunday, noon to 7 p.m. We will continue visiting schools, we'll continue visiting the community. All the schedule and information is at readyharris.org. And if folks need help with transportation, if folks have any questions, they can always call our Harris County Public Health line, 832-927-8787. I'll repeat my remarks in Spanish, and then we'll hear from Commissioner Ellis, from Dr. Rivera, and from Principal Said. Estoy aquí en la secundaria C.E. King, muy orgullosa de visitar el distrito escolar independiente Sheldon, y acabo de hablar con ciertos estudiantes, con administradores escolares y también trabajadores del Departamento de Salud Pública que están aquí administrando vacunas a nuestros niños, a nuestros estudiantes. Quiero darle las gracias a todos estos líderes escolares y también al Departamento de Salud Pública que ha estado trabajando en esto desde el año pasado, sin parar, desde hacer pruebas en la intemperie hasta ahora estas vacunas. En cuanto a las vacunaciones, nuestra comunidad realmente está poniendo de su parte. Ya más de 35%, casi 36% de todos los residentes del condado Harris están totalmente vacunados. Más del 45% han recibido al menos una dosis. En cuanto a la población elegible, las personas que califican para la vacuna, o sea, aquellos mayores de 12 años o de 12 y mayores, ya un 43% están completamente vacunados y casi 55% se han puesto al menos una dosis. Entonces, vamos muy bien. Muy, muy bien, pero sé que todavía hay personas que tienen un poco de nervios, tienen las dudas de la vacunación, entonces en eso estamos trabajando. Estos esfuerzos de la vacunación no suceden solos. Hay muchísimas iniciativas que hemos estado llevando a cabo desde diciembre. Más de 218 sedes de vacunación. Hemos visitado escuelas como esta, hemos visitado comunidades, iglesias, centros comunitarios, parques, todo tipo de comunidades. Y en cuanto a las escuelas, ya van 39 donde hemos administrado vacunas. Tenemos más y vamos a seguir viajando por todo el condado a llevar estas vacunas. Hemos estado también promoviendo información sobre las vacunas, una campaña de medios, yendo puerta a puerta. Hemos dado gift cards en la sede de vacunación de NRG, y aquí estamos anunciando una iniciativa más. Empezando la próxima semana, vamos a otorgar becas de $5,000, una beca por semana, durante al menos 10 semanas, para estudiantes que hayan sido vacunados a través del Departamento de Salud Pública del Condado Harris. Serán otorgadas esas becas a través de una rifa que se hará semanalmente, y los estudiantes recibirán esos fondos para cubrir la matrícula, el alojamiento, los libros en cualquier universidad o escuela, colegio comunitario, colegio público en el estado de Texas. Para ser elegible debe tener menos de 18 años, debe ser un estudiante, no debe haberse graduado aún y debe haber sido vacunado en una sede de vacunación del Departamento de Salud Pública del Condado Harris antes de la rifa. La primera rifa será el jueves 10 de junio y anunciaremos el ganador o la ganadora el siguiente día, el 11 de junio. Eso lo hemos diseñado viendo lo que está sucediendo a lo largo del país. Aquí en el Condado Harris, cuando empezamos las rifas de los gift cards en el NRG Park, subió la vacunación, la tasa de vacunación. Estábamos viendo 1,000 personas al día y empezaron a llegar 2,000 al día. Ahora también en Ohio hicieron una lotería, subió la tasa de vacunación un 28%. Se están anunciando iniciativas similares en el estado de Washington, en el estado de Nuevo México, y nosotros queremos servir a nuestros niños, a nuestros estudiantes. Entonces, si usted es un estudiante o un padre que todavía tiene dudas acerca de la vacunación, este es el momento. Acompáñenos, necesitamos su ayuda. Vamos muy bien en cuanto a las vacunaciones, los números siguen mejorando, pero todo esto lo tenemos que hacer es con su apoyo. We'll now hear from Commissioner Rodney Ellis, who's been an incredible partner in delivering these vaccines throughout the pandemic, supporting the community from the moment when the vaccines were not available. We were fighting hard to keep people safe, to get folks tested, up until now when the fight is about vaccinations. Commissioner Ellis, thank you for your support and leadership.
Thank you, Judge. Judge Hidalgo has done an incredible job under very difficult circumstances. And Judge, you ought to be commended for going to so many high schools. I know you have been to dozens of high schools. We're doing everything we can to get the word out. Dr. Rivera, thank you for your work. Principal Saeed, welcome to Pantherland. It's important that we come to where people are, and that's why Judge Hidalgo, Commissioner Garcia, Commissioners Ramsey and Cagle, we're all doing as much as we can. You know, this is a big region. We are bigger than some of the states that are offering a lottery. And Judge, if we had a lottery on the local level, I'd vote for doing it in a lottery. But it was creative on your part, on the part of your team, to offer scholarships to kids to participate. So look, we're here, we're doing everything we can. I have found the most effective way to get people to go and get the vaccination is if somebody who knows them tells them to go and do it. So to our friends who are watching through the media, if you know somebody who may not have gotten that vaccination, ask them to go. If you have any other bright ideas that we have not thought about, share them with us. We're doing as much as we can. I'm so looking forward to going back to life as normal. I know most of the students who go to this school have not seen it yet. Brand new state-of-the-art facility, $150-something million. I know we've had food distribution centers here. The principal is doing his job, so get the word out. Judge, thank you for your leadership.
Thank you, Commissioner. Dr. Rivera. Good morning, everyone. So today we're here just to thank again Judge Hidalgo. Thank you, Commissioner Ellis. Thank you to the entire staff at Sheldon ISD. You all have been amazing partners, not just for vaccination, but throughout this entire pandemic. We were joking around the late night conversations and everything that we've had to try to get kids tested, to try to get families tested, and now to get kids and families vaccinated. And unfortunately, that still continues. We're still continuing to urge family members, get vaccinated, have your kids vaccinated. Harris County Public Health has gone to almost 40 schools and counting. We're partnering with more than 15 school districts, and we're partnering with other healthcare partners around the region to try to get as many people vaccinated, but especially to now get our teenagers vaccinated. Unfortunately, so far, we've only vaccinated around 23% of the 12 to 19-year-olds, which is a great accomplishment, but we still have more to go. Because unfortunately, what we've seen is that around 25% of all the cases now are in children, because they're the ones that haven't gotten vaccinated so far. And there's still children that can't get vaccinated. If you're under 12 years old, you can't get vaccinated yet. And so let's try our best to protect all those kids that can't get vaccinated yet. Let's get vaccinated if we have the position to. If we're over 12, now there's this amazing scholarship program that we're so excited to talk about. Unfortunately, we know that kids still can get hospitalized. More than 350 children have died across the U.S., so let's try to prevent that. As we're seeing decreases throughout the county, we're almost there. So thank you, everyone, for all of your efforts. We are so encouraged, and we are so grateful to the community. And again, thank you so much to Sheldon ISD for having us here. And I'll just quickly repeat my remarks in Spanish. Buenos días a toda la comunidad. Muchísimas gracias a Juez Hidalgo. Muchísimas gracias, Commissioner Ellis, y a toda la comunidad de aquí de Sheldon ISD. Hemos estado trabajando juntos desde el principio de esta pandemia. Hemos estado trabajando para que todo el mundo pueda hacerse las pruebas, y ahora estamos tratando de que todo el mundo se vacune, especialmente todos los niños. Desde las últimas semanas hemos podido empezar a vacunar a todos los niños arriba de 12 años, todos los niños de 12 a 19 años. Desafortunadamente, todavía solo hemos podido vacunar alrededor del 23% de esa comunidad aquí en el condado de Harris. Entonces, si usted está elegible, si sus hijos están elegibles, si tienen más de 12 años, por favor, regístrense, pónganse la vacuna. Ahorita el condado de Harris tiene sitios de vacunación en casi 40 escuelas. Estamos trabajando con más de 15 distritos escolares y estamos trabajando con muchas otras organizaciones de salud a través de todo el condado para que la vacuna sea accesible para cualquiera que lo quiera. Y ahora que tenemos este programa de donde se pueden ganar becas para poder ir a la universidad si se ponen la vacuna. Es un programa increíble que tiene la iniciativa de la juez Hidalgo. Entonces, pongamos nuestra parte, todavía no salimos de esto desafortunadamente. Especialmente protejamos a todos esos niños que no se pueden poner todavía la vacuna. Muchísimas gracias a todos ustedes por todo su trabajo hasta ahora y sigamos esta lucha.
Thank you. We'll hear from Dr. Ralph Said, principal of C. King High School.
Thank you, Judge. We're so grateful to Judge Hidalgo, and thank you for being here, Commissioner, and Dr. Rivera. This has been a blessing to us, and I know there are parents who are still hesitant. This is an affirming thing for our kids and our parents and our staff that we are offering the vaccine. We're looking forward to a regular school next year. About 95 to 96% of our kids are coming back, and a 6A high school where enrollment is almost 3,000 students, we want our kids back. I know how much they have missed. And this vaccine, it provides us an opportunity to actually teach our kids face-to-face, have them. I know they're missing their teachers. I know teachers are missing their students. So thank you so much for affording us this opportunity. And Judge, with this $5,000 scholarship, I'm telling you, that's the last straw that's going to get our kids back. And right now it's the graduation season, so we know kids are graduating that may use this money. And if your name is called, as Judge said, for the next 10 weeks, come on, this is for you. College, tuition, books, and room and board expenses. So we are grateful. Thank you so much to Public Health and also Judge. Appreciate it. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. We'll take any questions. Ahora por las decisiones a nivel estatal, no será requerimiento el tener una vacuna para enviar a los estudiantes a la escuela, pero eso no significa que no debamos vacunar a los niños. Así como se les pone vacunas contra otro tipo de enfermedades, esta es aún más importante porque sabemos lo peligroso que es este virus. No se trata solo de usted, cuando tiene ni tampoco de su niño. Cuando tiene un niño que no está vacunado, ese niño, ese estudiante, puede transmitir el virus. Parte del milagro de esta vacuna es que no solamente lo protege a uno contra enfermedades serias, sino que también previene el contagio. Y eso es lo que necesitamos para erradicar este virus, para poder seguir adelante, regresar a la normalidad y no tener esa preocupación de contagiar a aquellas otras personas que no se han puesto la vacuna. Espero que sigan ayudando a la comunidad a llegar al punto donde debemos llegar. A una gran mayoría de personas vacunadas, vamos muy bien en camino. Esas vacunas son eficaces, son seguras, estamos liderando el mundo en cuanto a la vacunación. Debemos ver eso como un orgullo, un privilegio, el hecho de que tenemos tantas vacunas disponibles aquí en nuestro condado. Y quiero una nota brevemente acerca de la rifa. Para participar en la rifa que hemos anunciado, no se le pide ninguna prueba de ciudadanía. Entonces, si se pone la vacuna a través del Departamento de Salud Pública, recuerden, no se le pide identificación, no se le pide seguro médico, no se le pide prueba de ciudadanía. Y si se ha vacunado su hijo, su estudiante, a través del Departamento de Salud Pública, y ellos ganan la rifa, igual, no se les pedirá nada de eso, se les otorgará el premio de los $5,000 para que puedan seguir adelante en sus estudios. El gobernador ha tomado la decisión de eliminar el cubrebocas en las escuelas. Me preocupa por una parte las personas que no se han vacunado, porque aquellas personas que no se han puesto la vacuna, pues no tienen ninguna inmunidad especial. Si no han tenido el virus, no es porque sean superhéroes ni sean inmunes, simplemente han tenido buena suerte por ahora. Entonces, no quiero que se esparce el virus entre las personas que no se han puesto la vacuna. Pero ahí también, bueno, no podemos solamente hablar del gobernador. Eso está en manos de los residentes que no se han vacunado. Si quiere tener esa seguridad, ayudar a la comunidad a que no vuelva a haber un resurgimiento de los casos, lo que tiene que hacer es ponerse usted la vacuna. Si ya la tiene, mire, puede andar la recomendación desde el gobierno federal hasta nosotros localmente. Aquellas personas vacunadas pueden con seguridad andar sin mascarilla, ir a cualquier tipo de reunión. Le cuento, es un alivio total, es un alivio completamente saber que uno está protegido contra ese virus y que no está contaminando a la demás gente.
¿Qué se necesita y cuándo se espera?
Nuestro nivel de riesgo lo hemos diseñado de acuerdo a varias metas, varios hitos diseñados por expertos de salud pública, por académicos y doctores. Ahora estamos en nivel amarillo porque hemos llegado a todas esas metas. Para llegar a verde hay dos metas más que tenemos que alcanzar. Una es tenemos que tener menos de 10 casos semanales por 100,000 residentes. En este momento estamos en 21.5. Vamos en camino, van bajando el número de casos por 100,000 residentes en el condado Harris. La otra meta que no hemos alcanzado aún es el porcentaje de las UCIs que tienen COVID. Ahora vamos a alrededor del 10% de las UCIs son pacientes de COVID. Tenemos que llegar a un 5%. Vamos en camino. Es atenible, absolutamente es algo que podemos alcanzar. Pero la única manera de llegar a eso y regresar totalmente a la normalidad es a través de las vacunas. Thank you guys so much.
June
11. Thank you so much.
Let us know if we can help you with anything as far as education.
For a senior, yeah. Senior event.
If it wasn't for that,
I think it happened to you that you want.
Si sabe que si me permite, yo le mando un niño.
And then we have a vaccination.